All right. Tickled to death. Didn't have to buy another computer.
Hey guys, a couple years ago when we got this Jaguar, the air condition didn't work, but I'll show you in a minute. I changed the dual coolant bypass valves. Everything still didn't work, but I could tell the air condition was working because the lines would get cold, hot on one side, cold on the other. But when you grab the heater core lines, it was pumping hot water in, even though I had replaced it. Then I went to this computer control module, climate control module, I guess is what you call it. When I got into really analyzing it, I found a burnt tracing right here. Right there is a burnt tracing. A good light for you guys. But you see that right there? It's all black. Burnt tracing right there. So I soldered a jumper wire from here to there. Then on the back side, I had to solder a jumper wire from here to here because we got a burnt tracing right there. Focus it. Right there. That snapped. So I soldered these two lines together and it has been working fine ever since. The other day, the granddaughter on the dual climate control, right? Well, wife had it really cold, the air conditioning, and the granddaughter was complaining about it being too cold, and she reached up and turned the heat up on her side. So one side's the air conditioning, the other side's the heat. The right side has not worked since. And the only thing I can find here, right here, see this discoloration running along here? Right there. When I put a volt ohmmeter, tag it there and there, I'm not getting any conductivity, which makes me think that this tracing right there is bad. So we're going to try and put a jumper there and there and see if it starts working. And if that is the case, we're going to need to solder it up. Okay, see if we turn it to our diode and our ohm tester, turn the speaker on, we touch these wires together. Should be talking. See, I'm not getting anything here. See, nothing. So to check the wire, all we gotta do is go from here. So our wire is good. So let's put a jumper on there and see what happens. What I can come up with here. Okay, guys, here's what I'm going to try and do. I got a jumpers going. Had to go find jumpers on something else and cut off and just tie them together. I don't know if it's going to focus or not. So I'm going to make sure this is right, but if this works, I'm going to have to solder something up because I can't risk driving down the road and this bouncing loose. You know what I'm saying?
It only takes 4 screws to take the glove box out. There's your filter. But right there is your heater core lines. It's going to shoot the bypass off. And the way I diagnosed this was I put my hand up here and felt these lines. And one of them wasn't hot, and one of them was, and that told me, or I still had hot water flowing through these, even though the coolant bypass was supposed to be shut off. Normally, it is on when you start the car, it'll be on, and when your air conditioning kicks on, it's supposed to shut that valve off, and the valve is at the bottom of the radiator, and originally, I thought it was the actuators over here. For the doors, but they all move just fine. We got some actuators up there too.
Disconnect this one and you can pull your glove box out, and then this goes to the coolant, to the climate control module. All right, guys, We got cold air coming out of the right side now. So that jumper, that lead right there, the tracing didn't burn in half, but it was enough. Cold air, all right. We have it on both sides. So if you do this repair, do not push that dual button. All right. And the way to really check it is you reach up here and grab these lines. And make sure there's no hot water going through either one of them. All right, guys, I don't know if you can hear this or not with the air blowing, but I've got cold on both sides. What had happened, I mean, I had fixed that a couple years ago, and it worked fine for 2 or 3 years until there's our jumpers. We're gonna have to solder that imperfect because those jumpers aren't really, if you go hit a big pothole or something, it could short everything out. They were going down the road and my granddaughter turned the heat up on her side, which somehow or another messed up that tracing. From this point on, we cannot hit that dual. We should be able to, but we obviously can't if we want to maintain cold air coming out of both sides. This side always worked. All right, tickled to death. Didn't have to buy another computer. Let's go through cycles here. It's kicking into overdrive. All right, cold air. It's up to operating temperature. Because what was happening is we always had cold air out of here after the granddaughter did that, but this side was blowing out hot air and the wife was just doing this and shutting the vent off. But so good deal. Good deal. I'm just running it through paces, make sure it works. You see, we're now up to operating temperature. Okay, this is going to be hard, but I'm gonna try. Afraid I'm gonna have to give me a hemostat or something like that to be able to. I can't find small enough wire. All right, this is what I'm trying for, that right there, just like that. Let's tin this up real good first. So as I get my soldering iron up to temperature, I know, you guys that solder for a living are gonna laugh at me, I know. Just so worried because you hit those in, you hit that transistor there and you're screwed, you know. I really would like to get some more solder on this upper one here.
Well, I don't know, guys. What do you think? I'm not very good. I'm too old. My hands are all shaky, but what do you think?
I think what I'm going to do is put an ohm meter on and make sure it ohms out, and then we're going to try it. So to put it back in here, find our screws. And this is done with a T7 screwdriver. You need to make sure you use a good screwdriver. Remember, you're screwing into plastic. So I learned how to solder by a man named Bob Cravens. He's dead now. He made a living fixing stereos out of cars. He'd go to the junkyard and they'd give him all their car stereos and he'd take them home and fix them. He didn't use special equipment or anything. See, these things are sort of misleading. He would just look at those tracings like that or look for a pop cap or a burnt resistor. And basically he just did what I just did and he could fix like 80% of all car stereos. And he's the one who taught me how to solder. I was amazed at him. Eighth grade education and he could fix any car stereo.
To put this back in here, it's only got one screw and these two clips right here. And it just clips. It just clips under here and screws into there. So it just goes just like that. So we gotta hook these electrical connections back up. Okay, that is a T30 bit. All of these are T30s. And so we're gonna go ahead and put everything back together here. They give you a charcoal filter, but look at that gap. That doesn't make any sense, does it? Or over there. And you got that stud sticking out that it goes into there. So when you open your inside air, that door right there is gonna open. And it's supposed to filter through there.
Please subscribe and smash that notification bell. Have a blessed day.